that was the whole thing that Leonard Peltier went down for. It's just a classic case of injustice, and we all know that in Indian country, this is a strong possibility. And Leonard, unfortunately, has been a scapegoat in this whole wounded knee situation.
Sacrifice your freedom. Sacrifice your prayer. Take away your language. Cut off all your hair.
Hi, Leonard.
I was in the middle of making this record, and one day he called me on the phone and he was talking to me. And I thought, everybody else has described Leonard Peltier's situation, but nobody's ever heard him speak on his own behalf to tell the story himself.
My name is Leonard Peltier. I am a Lakota and Anishinaabe. And I'm living in the United States Penitentiary, which is the swiftest growing Indian reservations in the country. I've been in prison since 1976 for an incident that took place on the Ogallala Lakota Nation. There was a shootout between members of the American Indian Movement and the FBI and the local sheriffs, state troopers. Two agents were killed and one Indian was murdered. Were charged with the deaths of the FBI agents. My co-defendants were found not guilty by reasons of self-defense. My case was separated and I was found guilty before a jury of non-Indian people. The prosecutor stated that they did not know who killed their agents, nor did he know what participation Leonard Peltier may have played in it. But someone has to pay for the crime.
When we did that, we put the voice with this music and everything. It was just like, oh my God, this is something that to feel Leonard Peltier's situation, not the information, but to feel it. I can't think of a stronger way to do it.
There's a lot of nights that I played myself and can't understand why this hell and this terror that I've been going through for 21 years hasn't ended.
Some kind of an ancient rite of some sort, the sacrifice that you make. And he survives by getting good out of the sacrifice. I mean, how else can he survive?
I'm guilty of standing up for my people's rights. I'm guilty of trying to stop the oppression that I've experienced and I've seen my people experience.
I've gone too far now to start backing down. I don't give up. Not until my people are free will I give up. And if I have to sacrifice some more, then I sacrifice some more.